This road. It can't be. Annika?
Edward! Do you have any kids?
What? I used to, yes.
Used to?
I had a daughter. She was your age.
What was your name?
Who?
Your daughter.
Rosie. Her name was Rosie.
Rosie. Beautiful name.
Why did I take this road? Why did it have to be raining that day? It was all my fault. Again? I don't need to be reminded of this route.
Your daughter wasn't the only one who died that night.
Andrea never blamed me for the accident, but I did. Lives were destroyed because I took a shortcut. Hell started that night.
The other driver had a family, too.
It should have been me. I should have been the one to die. Not Rosie. Andrea and I got away with minor injuries. Rosie was already dead when she reached the hospital. Her name was Carol. She was going home from work.
I can't bear to look at this anymore. I need to leave.
Thing is Carol from the accident. Is that the fire station?
Thank you.
here, too.
There's someone in this world that you need to find.
Someone here? Who? Seems a valve is missing. Now we're really close to whatever the hell that thing is. No comment. Beautiful flag. Suppose they have to find a way to pass the time. Why is there a door here? Thank you. So where is this person I must find? Real-life heroes. He felt like a failing father. Wow. I need to watch my step. Feels unreal. God, even the fire chief was covering up Annika's death.
You dedicate your whole life to helping others. That's what the chief did his whole life. He was so dedicated to the fire department that he often forgot he had to be a father to his son. This time he didn't forget. And so he colluded with the sheriff to drop the investigation and protect their sons. Keith Bradley was a noble man, but he helped cover up the death of a little girl. What do you decide? Should Keith Bradley really be forgiven or pay for his crime?
Hopefully, this is the last time. The chief can be forgiven for being a good man. I just made a mistake.
You're getting close to where I died.